When grace shows, disgrace disappears. The grace of God is God in a race. Any race of life that is devoid of God is doomed for failure. Without the grace of God, no one can become all that God wants them to become. Grace is unmerited favor. Grace is what saves us from condemnation. Without grace, men cannot reign in this life. Without grace, condemnation is inevitable. Without grace, all human race will be deserving of death because all of us are guilty of sin. Grace is what declares us acquitted and discharged with no traces of wrong whatsoever. The Word of God says, "For all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, being justified freely by His grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus." Jesus is grace personified. The Word of God says, "And the Word became flesh and made His dwelling among us. We have seen His glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth." Truth and grace came by Jesus Christ. Grace is a supernatural enablement that is beyond human capability. With grace, you will be able to do what naturally you could not do. Any area of a man's life he is still struggling with is the area he has received the least grace or refused to use the grace that is given to him. Today, if you repent of your ways and accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, you will receive this grace to reign in life. According to the riches of God's grace, He has forgiven us our sins. In Him, we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins, in accordance with the riches of God's grace. The Word of God says, "For if by the one man's offense death reigned through the one, much more those who receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness will reign in life through the one Jesus Christ." Romans 5 verse 17. To reign in life is by having two things: receiving the abundance of grace and receiving the gift of righteousness. God is giving you abundant grace to reign in life in the name of Jesus Christ. Grace makes great. The Apostle Paul said, "But by the grace of God, I am what I am. And His grace toward me was not in vain, but I labored more abundantly than they all. Yet not I, but the grace of God which was with me." 1 Corinthians 15 verse 10. That addiction will be broken by the grace of God. Your family will be saved by the grace of God. You will go to heaven by the grace of God. You will live in divine health by the grace of God. Anything you want to become in Christ Jesus, you can become by the grace of God. God's grace is always sufficient to make you succeed in everything you do. Grace doesn't exempt you from laboring. When you labor in grace, you cannot end up in disgrace. When you strive for mastery in grace, you cannot end up defeated. There are different kinds of grace. The kind of grace you have will determine the kind of results you command. That is what we call great grace, the kind of grace that was upon the apostles when they gathered together in communion. When you receive great grace, you will do greater works. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "The works that I do, will you do? And greater works than this will you do because I go to the Father." The apostles did great works after the departure of Jesus. And with great power, the apostles gave witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. Today, this great grace is coming upon you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Great grace makes great men. It is not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit of grace. So he answered and said to me, "This is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel. Not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord of hosts. Who are you, O great mountain? Before Zerubbabel, you shall become a plain, and he shall bring forth the capstone with shouts of grace, grace to it. Moreover, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, the hands of Zerubbabel have laid the foundation of this temple. His hands shall also finish it. Then you will know that the Lord of hosts has sent me to you. For who has despised the day of small things? For these seven rejoice to see the plumb line in the hand of Zerubbabel. They are the eyes of the Lord, which scan to and fro throughout the whole earth. If you can beat mountains down to become plain, you need grace. When grace screams, mountains are shattered. I see grace screaming in your life to bring any mountain down in the name of Jesus Christ. The hands of Zerubbabel has laid the foundation, and his hands also shall finish it. You will lay a foundation and finish it in the name of Jesus Christ. Grace is what makes you start something and finish. With grace, the beginning cannot be despised, because though the beginning might look small, the latter end shall greatly increase. There is the ministry grace which God gives to his ministers. There is also exceeding abundant grace. The more weak you are, the more the grace of God strengthens you. The more you sin, the more the grace of God abounds to put you on track with God again. Apostle Paul said he was the chief of all sinners. But then the secret to his success was the grace of God. He says, and the grace of our Lord was exceedingly abundant with faith and love which are in Christ Jesus. We can always approach God's throne of grace to find grace in times of need. Let us then approach the throne of grace with confidence so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. Grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. To obtain the grace of God is by faith, for it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves, it is the gift of God. Grace is a gift just the same way salvation is a gift. Today, if you believe more, you will receive more grace, and of his fullness we have all received, and grace for grace. For the Lord was given through Moses, but grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has seen God at any time. The only begotten Son, who is in the bosom of the Father, he has declared him. Out of the fullness of Jesus, you have received grace for grace. May grace be multiplied to you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.